Rob.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Rob's Rogues and the Batman Universe. And today we're taking a look at the Justice League Dark, DC Comics New 52, and Ash as a figure. What? Let me try that again. A Justice League Dark, DC Comics New 52, and Ash as... Huh. And Ash as... All right, hold on. I have to try something.
You're a world. And they are so they see lives and they are beating beats.
Okay, we'll try it again. Justice League Dark DC Comics New 52 Zatanna. Whew, okay, there, it worked that time. So, here is the new 52 version of Zatanna. Yeah, this was definitely a figure I have been wanting to pick up just for the nostalgic of the Batman animated series. I really liked her character representation in the Forever Evil storyline. I really haven't read any of the Justice League Dark comics or picked them up. Unless they crossed over into the Forever Evil storyline. So it was nice to see Zatanna again, since I hadn't really read her in quite a while, and she seems very much like the Zatanna we all know and love, so I really appreciate that from DC Comics. We'll take a look at the packaging. Let me stop the rambling here. I like the purple. Really kind of fits Zatanna's character, even though she's mostly, you know, in blacks and whites, but I kind of like that as well with the traditional DC Comics box. There is the preview image, and I'm glad the figure does not look like this in the face at all. I didn't like the look of how they sculpted the preview image, and I thought, oh, please don't let her face look like this. She looks too old, and I think she looks Shannon Doherty-ish. You think so? A little bit there? Maybe that's a little hint. She is, you know, a sorceress, charmed, you know? Okay. I think the face looks much, much better here. I know sometimes in reverse we'll say, oh, I wish they would have got the face sculpt to look like this. And some of these are pictures, it's a preview image. It's a prototype of, like, this is the figure we want to create. And sometimes the prototype looks really, really good, and then the figure isn't executed as well as it should be. I'm much happier with this. I know they kind of have her... with her arms and legs, you know, kind of outreached a little bit or stretched out. But she looks a little too big, but she looks nice and slender as the way I would expect her to look. Here is the side panel art, which I think she kind of looks a little huntress here a little bit. Maybe that's just me. But again, I do like the silhouettes on the package. It's really kind of cool. I'm cutting these out and saving them. I don't know what I'm going to do with them. I probably should just throw the whole entire box away, but hey, you'll have that. Here is the back of the package, and we'll get to the bottom in just a second. Now, if you remember, let me turn this extra little light off, a little glare. From Deadshot's write-up, here is a Zatanna. It says, based on her appearance in DC Comics, a new 52 Justice League Dark, comes the mistress of magic, Zatanna. Pretty basic write-up. Okay, they probably could have written a little bit more. Sounds kind of generic. They don't have to do that at all. When we get to the next figure, you'll see what I mean from there. The other figures, I would say, that are in this wave or are coming out. Three of these figures are out already. Of course, Zatanna. Constantine came out. And then just recently, Zatanna. Stargirl came out. Hawkman is not out yet, and this looks like a beautiful figure. This is definitely going to be one I'm probably going to pick up in 2015. So we will stop all the rambling here. We will get Zatanna out of package, and we will get a closer look at Zatanna. All right, we have Zatanna out of package, and I believe I misspoke. I said Forever Evil. I'm sure they had some Forever Evil stuff going on, and I did see her from time to time, but the issue I was, or the series I was actually thinking about, was the Trinity War that heavily featured Justice League Dark members, and for a little bit of a time there, the Justice League was having an open roll call, and Zatanna was trying to get on the main Justice League as opposed to being on the Justice League Dark. So I was really kind of hoping she would end back up as a Justice League member. I think that's where she should be. I know there's a lot of people who like the Justice League Dark series, but I would like to see her in the main Justice League myself. So anyway, now that I got that out of the way, a really cool figure. And I kind of said, oh, it'd be really cool if, you know, she was in her top and tails or whatever. Well, taking the figure out of the package, and a lot of times in the comics, we don't see much of the costume if the hero is wearing cape. But when I took her out of the package, she is wearing her tails from her jacket. So if you wanted to, if you thought, oh, I don't like this cape on her, it's a nice, flimsy, rubbery cape. It does weigh her back a little bit. I'll get into that when I get to the articulation. But I think, and it goes all the way up to the neck and the collar, it looks like it's attached in here. So I think if you would pull this up, she may not be completely painted all the way, but if you were good at doing, you could probably cut out and around the shoulder and behind here and have her look quote unquote normally. And if you have your DC Universe Classics Zatanna like I have here, she does come with her magic wand, which I haven't ever taken it out. As you can see, it's still tied there as I just dropped the figure. Way to go, Rob. Okay, let's try that again. I'm not going to deal with taking it out because it doesn't really fit in her hand very well loosely. But if I wanted to, I could take out the wand and place it probably in this hand. It looks like it's the only hand that is really going to hold the wand. But what she could hold is her DC Universe Classics hat. Again, that I just dropped. This one I think I could be able to pick up without having to shut the camera off. Okay, there you go. Good footwork there, Rob. So I think you could get her to hold it if you so chose to do so. So this would be a nice little addition. Or if you don't have the DC Universe Classics and you've been collecting the Batman Arkham series, here's the Penguin's hat, which it looks a little too big on her, like she's Slash there. The DC Universe Classics hat really doesn't fit on her. But as far as a hat for her to hold, it would work. This one's really rubbery. So again, it could just be a hat, and she, I think, can hold on to this. Maybe. Maybe not. Yeah, there you go. So if you do have the Penguin, or you had the two-pack of a Penguin and one of the twins, and you had a single Penguin already, it would work. So a couple little different options if you want to kind of recreate Zatanna's normal look there. So anyway, moving on to the figure, another really well-sculpted figure. I'm not saying that it's perfect, and it's flawed in a few spots in the sculpting. In just different lights, her with her black lipstick, it looks like she's kind of puckering just a little bit. But it's a nice, clean sculpt. It's not going to be the Sculpted Figure of the Year award winner. But I still think it's a much better sculpt than the preview image that we saw. Another nice thing that DC Collectibles is doing with the women figures now, instead of that hard plastic hair that Wonder Woman has, a lot of the female figures now have this nice rubber hair, much like the capes, so you can get the female characters to turn their head if they have a whole mane of hair showing. That so that is nice as well. I don't know if you noticed in the hand here, there's this black mark. I thought, why is there a black line here? Well, with the type of gloves she's wearing, it goes over the middle finger, so they did that little extra added touch there, and of course they did it on that finger as well, and it goes down in between the fingers. You don't really see it in that one, but with this finger being open, they took the extra time to paint around that, and that must have been a very tedious amount of painting that had to have been done right there. So definitely a nice sculpted figure. There's not a lot going on it. You see the fishnets here. Now, I brought up the DC Universe Classics figure to kind of compare, at least in fishnets. Mattel actually made fishnets for Black Canary and for Zatanna both. You did have this bunching up kind of here in the back. So while it does look nice in the back of a leg, if you didn't have it turned around just right, it did look a little ugly. DC Collectibles went by the way of, you know what, we're just going to paint it on. Or it's part of the mold that it was. It doesn't feel like fishnets or anything. It's just in part in how it's painted. So I don't think it was individually painted. It must have been a part of the mold that just went around it and made these lines. That probably doesn't make any sense at all. There's no texture. It's just how the figure was made. So I'm not being like, oh, I wish there had fishnets on here. That would have been a pain in the butt to do just that much. And it probably would have looked like Mattel's. So the stuff that they did here is completely fine with me. Much like Deadshot, I do not see any paint errors anywhere, and there's not a lot. She's primarily just a black figure with a little bit of white. And sometimes a white can be a pain. There's no overspray, there's no black getting into the white, no white into the black. So a very, very clean figure. One thing I want to point out is DC Collectibles is going to be making figure stands for your figures. They used to come with them, and now they're going to sell them. So some people are like, I don't have to buy figure stands. I'll probably get some for the ones that didn't come with any. But as you can tell here, Zatanna does not have any holes in the bottom of her feet to be able to go onto a stand. And she is back heavy. I had to bend her ankles forward a little bit and actually get her to lean a little bit. I don't know if you can tell from the profile side. There she is leaning a little bit, so you don't notice it as much here. I'm not worried about her toppling forward as I am her toppling backwards. So she might be a back row character in my collection. So I just kind of wanted to point that out. You may want to watch where you're placing her in your collection, or get her kind of around some other characters to maybe lean on. I mean, I would feel comfortable placing her now that I can get her to stand like this, but if somebody would happen to topple over, I think she would go rather quickly. So just again, wanted to point that out. Let's get into articulation now. So the head is on a ball joint. It is slightly restricted due to the hair. I mean, yes, she can look. She won't go all the way around due to just the collar that is back here from the cape, but she can look left to the right very well. Not much up, down just a little. Arms would go in a full 360 on the ball and socket here, but the cape, even though it is soft and rubber, it's a little bit heavier in this spot. She does have a bicep swivel, single bend elbow, and that's it in the arm. So you can't get her arm, excuse me, to do a pose like this, like she's wanting to turn her hand to do some type of spell. There's no turn at the wrist. I think that's due to they didn't want to mess up this sculpt. I think they could have done it here. They could have put a cut right here, even though there were some nice little folds and creases. I would have wanted to be able to get her arm to turn rather than turn her whole arm right there, rather than have her hand. Or if there was a cut here in the elbow, that at least you could have turned the elbow over. No waist swivel. She has the T-jointed clear ball pegs. And these, sorry, Zatanna, to do this. People are like, when is DC Collectibles going to stop using the clear pegs? So, Zatanna, sorry that you're going to have to get this. Those are black. So, at least on this particular figure, they are not using the clear joints. So, if you're worried about the figures breaking, like, oh, those stupid clear pegs are breaking, they're using a solid color now, a solid black. So, maybe they have been listening and decided, you know what, that clear plastic is a little too brittle. So I think that's a nice little added touch. If nothing else, at least on this figure, I don't have to worry about the clear peg breaking through the center. On to the rest of the articulation. She has a high upper boot swivel and a single bend at the knee, and she bends at the ankle here. And again, like I said, that's flat. I had to kind of move it up a little bit in order to get her to stand. So she will stand, but you have to kind of make her lean just a little bit. So I don't have any other figures from the Justice League Dark. I saw Constantine at my local comic shop, Alter Ego Comics, but I'm not watching the Constantine series, and I know right now Constantine is trying to save its show. So for those of you that like the show, I hope it gets saved. Anything that's a DC property, I would definitely like to see it keep going so we get more DC content. But Constantine, for me, I think for the average person that might be into superheroes, Constantine kind of sounds like it's a hard sell. At least being on NBC, I don't know if I would have put it there. Maybe it should have come over to CW or Fox, maybe where it would work more towards the teen, mid to 20 range audience that maybe it's trying to shoot for. So I'll at least bring up one more figure to kind of show you how she looks. And here she is with Batman. So little do a reenactment of some of my favorite Batman animated series episodes. Since I'm not doing a Justice League Dark team, she is going to be standing with the Justice League itself. That's how I have a lot of my figures on my shelf. My new 52 figures are all kind of just together as one league. I may have some of them kind of grouped together depending on their team affiliations, but a definite nice figure to the collection. If you like the Zatanna figure, I think this is definitely one to pick up. Final thoughts for Zatanna. I'm kind of zoomed in on her eyes. That looks like she's looking over this way just a little bit. Eyes, for whatever reason, for some of the DC collectibles figures are hit or miss. The Supergirl figure kind of suffered from some wonky eyes. They're not crossed. It just looks like she's looking maybe not straight at you guys, but more over here. I would consider her a basic figure. There's nothing overly sculpted on the figure. The few things that are sculpted are done well, as far as the jacket and the V-neck and the chest area, as far as things that are sculpted. But just with a figure of it's a lot of black and wearing tight-fitting clothes, there's not much else to sculpt with. The cape is done very well. But that being said, it's a nice, simple figure. And it's a character that I definitely like from the animated series and the Justice League cartoon series, and just from the New 52, the handful of times that I've read her. So today we've been taking a look at the Justice League Dark New 52 Zatanna action figure.